What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to Devil's Details Diecast Custom Build Series. This is going to be interesting. I am participating in the Diecast Mafia Rat Rod build, and I can't decide which casting to use. So I got a lineup here of kind of bits and pieces of the ones I want to use. And yes, I want to use this John Deere tractor. We all know what rat rods look like. It's all, you know, they all kind of look the same. They're all basically bone shakers and, you know, rusty and crusty and dusty and dirty. So I kind of looked up on Google and looked for a few different ones and try to find something unique, because I don't want to just do what everybody else is going to do. That's not my style. I try to think of something out of the box. I did see a couple of coffin type ones that I thought were really cool, basically on the ground. And I did see a couple that had some really big rear tires, and that got me thinking about this little tractor I had and these tractor tires. So you can be rest assured that one of these cars is going to have a pair of the, well, these rear tractor tires on them. That's for sure. And maybe even the front tires, I don't know. But my thinking is, this is going to be a true rat rod, whereas it's going to be bits and pieces of each one of these castings, and probably something even out of my parts bin. True rat rods are basically junkyard finds. You know, they may start with a chassis from something or a body from something, and they may find a front end clip that fits on it, or they may mod it to fit on it, or they may want a wagon for the back, or they may want, you know, to move the cab more towards the back, or they may want rumble seats, or they may want to chop it so you can barely even fit inside of it, or you may have to lay down to drive it, or they may want no roof at all. So it's kind of like a lot like the Gaslands or Wastelands builds. Some of these guys just kind of find what they can find and put them together and put a big motor in it and don't worry about paint and don't worry about, you know, being all pretty. Sometimes the uglier the better. I don't want to just make it ugly to make it ugly, so I'm going to see what I can do on that end of it. But since I couldn't decide, I'm just going to break apart all of these cars and I'm going to start mixing and matching and see what fits and see what I like. And that's going to be my rat rod. So don't have much time to work on this. It is due July 15th and today is June 21st. So along with other builds I'm working on, this is going to kind of have to come together quickly. I do know I want an exposed motor, so probably going to stick with the jerry-rigged motor. I'm not a fan of gassers too much, so this is probably going to get the most sacrifice done to it. But we'll see what we come to. So should be a fun build as always, and this is, I think, my first Diecast Mafia build, if I'm not mistaken. So looking forward to that. I don't know what your bench looks like, but when you gotta take three castings apart to make a rat rod, kinda seems a little backwards. But here's what I'm working with so far. We got the jerry rig all chopped up. We got the Woody all chopped up. The Wiley's is semi chopped up. I've gone through a bunch of heavy-duty cutoff wheels. Probably see scraps here and there. I also broke my off-brand Dremel. I broke the lock on it, so I can't get the cutting shaft out. So I probably have to take this whole thing apart and try to... I broke this little lock off. So now I can't lock... I can't lock this to remove that. But anyway... So what I've done here is I've gotten the tractor wheels on the back, as you can see. I'm trying to get this lower, but I mean, I've pretty much gone as low as I can without cutting into the fenders, which I don't want to do. So I'm going to have to be happy enough with that. I've just been trying different tires on the front. I just put a little piano wire in there, so don't mind that. What I did also was I made a little axle tube for the tractor. The tractor was real pain in the ass. I think it was like press sealed together, so I had to do a lot of... I put it in the vise actually to try to pop it out, and then I had to just cut it with the Dremel. What I did was I melded the front of the Woody to the rear of the gasser, and my original thought was to put the front end of the Woody with the engine of the gasser underneath, which fit fine, but when I lined it up with the Jerry, it's too high. Kind of looks like a bird's beak. And I didn't like how it fit. Looks kind of cool from the front, but I mean, if this guy was driving, he would never be able to see over over the hood. So it's back to the drawing board. On the front end, you know, I'd like to put the engine a little further forward, because I kind of feel like even with the tires here, that the front end's kind of not long enough to match the back end. So even though I stretch the front, I feel like the tires should kind of be more up front instead of over here. So I'm just kind of going through what I got for parts and mishmashing everything together at this point. But as far as I'm concerned, the rear tires and the jerry-rigged casting is what we're going to go with so far. Hard to do this with one hand. My tripod doesn't fit my new phone, so I gotta get a new tripod for that. But in any event, we're going with the back tires here. Of course, they're not gonna be yellow, and we're going with the jerry rigged. I haven't decided if I'm gonna chop the top yet. I might chop off the back end, and we will lose the chrome interior and probably the glass as well. I don't think we're going to keep the glass, but I just have everything fitting in there for now, just to kind of see where I'm at with everything. So, any event, that's the update. Stay tuned. If I could only tell you how many cars went into making this rat rod, I would. Don't mind the tractor wheels. The rubber is off because I'm going to be painting them. But this is basically the build I'm going with. And just pull these off here. Look at this chassis. It's got a diaper dragger for the front. I don't remember the piece that I have here. I ended up cutting this chassis front end off because I thought the wheels were too close. They were going to be like right here. They're too close to the engine. I thought it needed to be extended out a little more. And then the Chevy Gasser original chassis is there with the original interior. Got the engine mounted, got this front end, probably from a doozy, I think, with the grill and the lights. Added two tubes of styrene for the extension, you know, for like steering mechanism, I guess. There's nothing under this. Just needed to take up some space and give it some, you know, semi-realism as far as a rat rod will go. And then, of course, the giant tractor tires will bring the back up a little bit. So we'll have actually a functional roller here. So all this is going to go into primer, all one color, and then I'll paint all my colors from there. But wanted to give you guys a shot of what it looks like. Definitely a feat of engineering here. And, you know, it looks like crap right now because it's all different cars stuck together. But once I hit it with the primer and get all the colors and weathering down, you know, it'll look fine. Plus, I did decide to keep the glass, so it will have a windshield, and it will have, I think it's just the back glass here that the gasser originally had. So decided to keep the windshield because, you know, not many rat rods will drive around with no windshield and no glass. I know there are some, but I figured this guy, you know, maybe wants to take it on the highway or the drag strip, and he's going to want a windshield. So that's what I decided. It will be removable in the final piece anyway, so if I don't like it, I'll take it out. So stick around. And if you remember, this is what we started with. Four different castings: the Woody, the Jerry Rigged, and the 41 Willys, along with this little John Deere tractor, to hopefully come up with some amalgam of a rat rod. And here's what we finally came up with. And here it is, folks. The rat rod that took three cars plus to create. was really fun to do this car, and a bit of a headache, but I think in the end, my vision came through, and I created a pretty badass coffin-style rat rod that I think will be unique to myself and my style of building, and unique to all the other builders out there. Right down from the tractor tires to the extended front to the four plus cars I think I used to build this, probably even more with all the different parts I used. Does roll. What I ended up doing for the paint is I just kind of gave it a black primer, and then I just dry brushed it with a gray just to kind of give it a weathered black paint look. I threw on some actual Bondo glazing and spot putty on some spots and just left it to dry just as if they were working on it, you know, work in progress, if you will. I haven't had a chance to get any paint going on it. Threw some decals on it so it didn't look so plain, because I did finish it and I was going to film it, and I just figured it looked a little plain, so threw some decals on it. Did the interior, as you can see. Did the seat belts. Did the rear fuel tank. A little bit on the steering wheel there, and a little bit on the... It's kind of had like a back roll bar kind of thing. I did take out the windshield and the glass. I just didn't like the way it looked. And in true rat rod fashion, I think it looked a little more badass without the glass. So I took the glass out. Little flame decal on the roof there. I painted that with a paint pen. And once that dried, I took some sandpaper to the top and just sanded the heck out of it, scratched it up and dulled it down. And then threw a decal on top and hit it with some dull coat to take the shine off the decal. Hit the engine with a Molotow pen and a Sharpie for the headers. I'm sorry, the valve covers. And that's about it. Chromed up the front a little bit. Show you the base. And it's Frankenstein glory. And there we have it. I'd like to thank Diecast Mafia for putting on the rat rod build. It's a lot of fun. And even though I've done a few rat rods in the past, I think this is the first one that I use multiple cars to bring to life. So now I got a bunch of car parts I need to find out what to do with. But I'm sure they'll make good fodder for the Gaslands. So thanks again, Diecast Mafia. Make sure you check out all the other builds. And until then, be well. I'm gonna go get some more.